engineering consultant in the world, particularly in the metal industry, cement industry, aluminium, steel, power, and all. And we are diversifying into IT, automation, business consulting. So I represent the IT and automation division and business consulting division. Prior to that, I was in a large enterprise steel producer of India. I don't want to name any company right now. But what I'm going to share my experience with you is by virtue of my experience in a large enterprise. So what I'm going to speak today, I'll try to highlight the inner contradictions of a large enterprise, the problems they are facing. And that, in effect, is affecting the market of IT and automations. Technologies are there. We have heard a lot of presentations on technology. But they have to be sold. They have to be marketed. They have to be installed. Who are going to be the buyers? One of the major sectors is the large enterprises. But what the story I'm going to unveil now, it will give you some insight, the problems being faced by the large enterprises. I hope there are some corporate level managers are here. They may take some cue. They may decide something to remove this aberration. There is a policy paralysis which is affecting the corporate management, lack of vision. So lack of, let me go to the presentations. I think that will be better, I think. So my context is my presentation is in the context of a large enterprise. When you say large enterprise, we mean there are multiple units, there are multiple locations, and each units are by and large independent. They don't care about the corporate presence. They take their own decisions. And there is a limited corporate role. In this context, I'm going to make my presentation. So this is a typical example of a large enterprise. There are multiple units, plant 1, plant 2, plant 3 I have added. There may be an R&D center. There may be an unified marketing division. This is a large setup. You can visualize the companies I am trying to represent, I am targeting. So my agenda today, maybe next 15 minutes, I'll try to be a bit fast and save some time for you. I'll speak about the dilemma, the inner contradictions being faced by these companies. Then I'll try to give my own solutions for sustainability. Let's go through. What is the present IT scenario? I'm trying to summarize. Most of the industries have adopted ERP. ERP is an established fact now. Along with ERP, SCM has also come and established. MES is making its presence felt. It is emerging. So I put it in a lesser circle. The size of the circle matters. And there are some legacy applications, which are bound to be there because of the historical reasons. So what are the problems and issues, and what are the imperatives and goals? Let me just go through. Legacy applications have evolved rather than planned. They are isolated rather than integrated. They are local rather than global. They are disparate. They are incompatible. They are inconsistent. So they are not, they are serving the local requirements, not the global requirements. What about ERP and SCM? They have established themselves. There is no way out. That is the decision. Business process automation has been established. So ERP has made its impact. Experiences vary from industry to industry. Some industries are very happy with ERP. Some industries are not. It has impacted the industry beyond doubt, no doubt. Obviously, it has come to stay. We have to manage ERP to get the best results. Potentials of ERP are yet to be exploited. It requires expertise, which is at a premium. So this is the ERP and SCM scenario. MES scenario is something like this. It is emerging. It is making its presence felt. It has the potential to bridge the gap between ERP and the process automation. It has the potential to improve operational efficiency. but it suffers lack of awareness. It requires aggressive marketing and awareness campaigns. This is where we stand today in India. This is just, I thought, how IT plays a role. IT is central to this, intensely involved in all the three stages, ERP, MES, and automation, and how it serves the industry, the large enterprises, the manufacturing companies. Most of the companies have gone for ERP. There is a process level automation at the bottom, ERP at the top, MES is emerging. So I'm coming back to the present scenario. Let us see. So here you'll see we have got IT resources are scattered and disorganized. There are multiple IT divisions. In each plant has got its own IT division. Corporate has office has got its own IT, R&D, marketing, so IT is scattered. It has got a serious problem when IT is scattered within a company. Even within a unit, now you can see I have put two more small red boxes. Those are local IT within an unit. If the unit is very large, it will have a defined IT division, undefined IT pockets. It may be a pocket with the operations division, it may be a pocket with the automation division. So this kind of scenario is prevalent today in many of the large enterprises. So what is the dilemma where I talked about? So it is disjointed, IT is disjointed. When I speak IT, you can always associate automation along with it. It is disjointed and captive to the units. Its strength varies across the units. Its resources are tied up in similar applications at multiple locations. This is a great wastage for a company, for such companies. Same applications are being repeated in n number of locations. Similar applications are not interoperable. Lack of standardizations and uniformity impedes rapid deployment of applications. Growth opportunities and motivational levels vary across the units. See, IT people are demoralized. IT comes under the service. The focus is always on operation. So there is always a conflict of growth and satisfaction and motivation level. This is what I have tried to highlight. So IT ought to serve the growing IT. What are the imperatives? IT has to serve with growing penetration. It has to become indispensable. But in actual practice, IT is getting a stepfatherly treatment or a stepmotherly treatment, whatever way you call it. It has to match the growing complexities, optimize its resources tied up at different units, chasing similar jobs, standardize and integrate its operations across locations, retain talent through better job satisfaction. That should be the ideal environment where IT can flourish. Let us see how we can achieve this. This is what the green box says. Let us look at my solutions. How to achieve this ideal environment within a large enterprise where IT and automation can flourish, can take decisions about purchase of your IT and automation products. So we must strategize. These industries, these companies must get out of this policy paralysis syndrome and strategize. So what is the strategy? IT has attained the critical mass and the velocity to escape from its traditional habitats into an independent orbit. Traditional habitats are the individual units. Independent orbit is an independent presence. That is what I'm going to focus. See, why I'm going to focus, I think I'll come back to this wrongly placed, this particular model. Anyway, I'm highlighting, you have got two options of IT. It can serve the organizations as a whole in an unified manner. In addition, it can also function as a net revenue earner. That is the ultimate goal of IT. So how we can achieve that, let us see. The future scenario, we must homogenize first phase. We must bring these small pockets of IT into the well-defined IT divisions. Then these are individual pockets have gone. Next step, we integrate. How we integrate? We remove these individual divisions which are captive to the individual units, bring at a central place, and you see that red thing is changing into some blue. So IT resources are now integrated. Once having done that, we have to create something. We have removed something. For what? We want to create an IT division, independent, integrated, and with a future outlook. So IT resources are integrated and optimized. That needs to be done in large enterprises. But at the same time, I must give some facility to the individual units, because I believe I cannot remove the entire IT. I must give back something for their local help. So these are small green boxes which we are putting it back, but the control is with the large green box at the center. This is the way the future scenario of IT should be in a larger enterprise. Not only IT, it also applies to automation. But how to achieve that? Having given a strategy, I must tell you how to achieve that. Let me see. This calls for some major planning at the corporate level. We must plan for the infrastructure. We must plan for the application systems. We must plan for the governance. Unfortunately, none of the large enterprises in India are following this. They are somehow managing things and allowing things to drift. And as a consequence, your entire IT and automation industry is only talking about not able to deliver the kind of services required by these industries. Sorry. So what is the infrastructure plan? It deals with the development of the infrastructure, a master data center. We must have an appropriate data center where we can apply the applications. What are the IT applications? Bringing all units of the company into a unified software regime in areas of ERP, MES, and MIS. Then what is governance plan? Unifying IT resource base into an independent IT divisions. Let us see. I think I'll try to finish within 5 minutes. Corporate plan will focus, infrastructure plan will focus on developments and consolidation. Application plan will focus on integration and unification. Governance plan will focus on organization tiers and growth models. Planning horizons, short-term 5 years, long-term 10 years. What is infrastructure plan? Short-term, CO means corporate office. Corporate office data center for corporate functions and migration at company level. There must be a corporate office data center. There should be a disaster recovery center. And it must be ready within 5 years. If it is not there for large enterprises, that needs to be done. For long term, they should move over from corporate to a master data center. That is what I mentioned, with an upgraded disaster recovery site in an integrated and unified manner. That will take care of the infrastructure. What about the applications? Many of these companies I know, they have not gone for HR and payroll systems because historically they have something in their own. They don't want to deviate from their historical legacy systems. Number two, the cost of implementing HR is very high with large number of employees. But it can be done in two phases, one at the corporate level, one at the unit level. That is why I have recommended certain units to be at the unit level also, IT. But in large enterprises, there are big units, there are small units. Big units have their IT, small units do not have ITs. So here I'm mentioning this corporate office should integrate the small units and bring into the ERP or MES platform. Then standardizations. In long term, re-engineer the existing ERP applications in the new hardware environment, the master data center. What is governance plan? Governance plan is, as I said, I have demonstrated, we must homogenize and create an independent IT divisions. We must have two level, at least two tiers of organizations, and choice among outsourcing, insourcing, and hybrid options. Governance plan regarding organization, step one, homogenization you can do, can be achieved by suitable administrative order. It doesn't call for a board level approval. The unit head can bring this kind of changes. He's capable of doing it. Unit head may be an executive director. He's quite capable of doing that. Step two is to create an IT division where you require a board approval and all that chairman's approval. Tiers I have explained, why do you require two tiers? Growth model, one is the complete outsourcing, the other is the in-house approach, and the other is the hybrid approach. So I am in favor of a hybrid approach for optimum utilization of internal talent with the flexibility to draw external support as and when required through SLAs. Why I am preferring hybrid approach? Some of you might say that outsourcing is always better, but you have to remember these large companies, due to historical reasons, have a large internal IT manpower. They cannot be whisked away. So, hum log kya kar raha hai, ek bada division, aap jaiye, bhag jaiye, bahar. That is not possible. So, you have to take their interest. So, a hybrid approach will be a better approach to create this new IT division. How to implement? This, I think, this is about project management. Most challenging among the three stages. A consultant is required to help project preparation and management. You split the entire plan into a number of executable packages, then select suitable implementation partner or vendors for efficient project implementation. Create your own core team, fortify your knowledge base. Evolve a policy of maintenance and sustenance. This is very important. I have seen many of the projects. They create, then they deteriorate it. They cannot maintain it internally. You must be having a policy of maintenance, either with in-house talent or with outsourcing policies. Then regarding implementations, I have said most important part is this. You should have your own core team. You should have a partner, implementation partner, you should have a consultant that will give you the most optimum in respect of risk and effort. So sustainability, once you have done that, you have achieved the goals of sustainability. Now you are in a position to optimize and rationalize resources, consolidate your domain knowledge, integrate and interoperate your systems, etc., etc. So once you have done that, you have already achieved, and that will sustain your organizations in the long run. So what you have done at the end, you have created an infrastructure, you have created an application environment, you have created a governance system to send your organizations to higher orbits of growth and prosperity. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Great presentation to end
Yes. We have the last presentation of the day. I request, this is an unscheduled presentation. I request the speakers to finish in 15 minutes so that we can break for the lunch.
I would like to call upon our next speakers, Mr. C.K. Pari and Mr. A.P. Sahu, to give a presentation on asset management and production planning control by Vizag Steel.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm C.K. Pari from Vizag Steel. I'll be talking about how asset management is taken care by Vizag Steel. Vizag Steel has come a long way from this mainframe era to open system in 2003. All the applications were migrated to open systems from mainframe. And later, as you can see, here this all these masters, we have got more than this 10,000 equipments codified for our this master data management purpose, and more than 90,000 assemblies were codified. More than 333 drawings were codified. So to start with, when the masters are ready, we had got the requirements by the customers, the different departments. We started taking care what exactly they require for asset management, and we have a series of MOUs with them. We have got this customer satisfaction surveys conducted regularly. So based on the requirement, what we have found out that the asset management software what we have given is to be modified a little bit to suit the requirements of the customer. And as you know, that recently all the people, they have become very much IT savvy, and they have become very much demanding. So slowly we are migrating most of our applications to web applications. So we have got in our asset management the maintenance management system, the repairs of system, and recently we have included inventory management system to take care of the departmental stores activities. And we have got the central maintenance management system to take care of the work order management activities. And we have got the document management system in place where more than 200,000 documents are digitized, the land records and all these health records of the employees, they are digitized. And we have got this enterprise project management 2010 that is implemented in Vizag Steel to take care of this capital repair, as you can see in the second column there, the capital repair activities, those are managed by the enterprise project management what is implemented. So here, this is a maintenance process. I will not go details into it. So this is the normal maintenance process what is followed. And the work order, as I said, we have got now this web-based central maintenance management system, which actually helps the customers to generate their work order and give feedback and get the history of all the equipments. So these are what we are achieving by this asset management and what we are doing. And we have got condition monitoring. Here we have got a centralized image repository and the web-based system that is developed and implemented to take care of all the condition monitoring parameters. And the digital images of drawings are in single central repository, and all the now for all the procurement activities, now we are sending the digitized drawings by email to the suppliers. And web-based inventory management system is developed and being implemented across the departments, and where we can know the material availability status, pipeline quantities, the critical quantities, consumption details, spares availability status at different locations, and these are the facilities given to generate the plan for different maintenance activity. And we have got effective MIS, and we have got this work content management system to take care of the jobs which are offloaded for maintenance of equipments, starting from the job generation till billing. Yeah, this is the repair process. I think I'll quickly skip all these slides. This is the system where we take care of the repair of equipments or assemblies. We have got a separate shop, engineering shops and foundry shop, where this system facilitates this ESF department to take care of the repairs. There they have got their own plan of the repair activities, and that MIS can be generated for the management to view. And the user departments can monitor the status of the job request from their desktop. That is one facility we are providing to the users. We have got more than 50 departments that is actually spreading throughout that vast area of Visakhapatnam steel plant. So all the departments, whatever job request they are giving, they can monitor. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. Because time is very short, I will be very brief. Maybe it is 7 to 8 minutes. So this presentation is quite related to our earlier speaker, Mr. Tanmay Rai, because ours is the steel industry having 3.4 million ton capacity. We are having a separate IT division headed by Sri KVSS Rajeshwar Rao, DGM in charge. Now, as he said, Mr. Tanmay, that we are also having pockets of IT in individual departments.
In steel melting shop, in rolling mills, in PPM, in marketing, everywhere we have pockets of software. So now the question is there, how to integrate all those things? Because as he said, being a steel industry, always management focuses on production. And then comes IT. And it is very difficult to implement a system, be it a small. The system may be very good. Very good programs will be there. Logics are there. Fine. But if it cannot be implemented, then it's of no use. Now, our PPC, the purpose of the PPC, that is production planning and control, is to achieve the targeted production quantity by proper planning of the plant production, by ensuring optimum capacity utilization of the resources, proper inventory management. It also aims at tracking of orders, hits, and products at every stage and generates test certificate for the dispatch products. The system is divided into 6 basic modules. That is, first is marketing. Marketing, the first module is marketing. It deals with the production planning, order management, product tracking. These are the basic functions of PPC: production planning, order management, product tracking, progress control, warehouse management, dispatch management, and lab analysis to give test certificate to our end users. So these are all 6 modules. First, it starts with marketing. Marketing, it generates marketing order, and it deals with the dispatch order management. Then comes PPM module.
PPM module, planning module, that surplus stock allotment to orders, generation of planned heats, issue of tapping instruction, generation of bill stacking plan, generation of IMCN, and management of value added steel products. And then comes the QATD, quality, design of orders for production, analysis and decision, declaration of internal grade, declaration of final grade, defective declarations, and finally, it generates online test certificate for our customers.